That's my favorite part.
Some sarcasm, right?
No, there was no sarcasm. I mean, when you lose the fight, you don't get to sit here.
I mean, you're not wrong.
So anyway, Drew, how about that fight? You've obviously, you're a guy that you don't want boring fights. You don't want boring corners. Even at meeting, you want stars in these exciting moments. So this is exactly what you expected from your dance partner tonight.
Yeah, absolutely. He was a far cooler individual than I thought he was. And he was more technical than I assumed he was. I knew he was very athletic and chaotic. So the game plan going in was to stay calm and collected. Patiently dangerous. But man, that second round, he tried to draw me into a firefight. And it was pretty exciting.
So when he dodged that flare from you and started to the robot, was any part of you just like, all right, F the game plan. I'm just going to run out.
No, that was a lot of fun. I mean, we're all entertainers. Those are the type of dance partners that I want to get in the cage with. And that was the first time anyone's ever done that to me. And so I was just enjoying it like everyone else. Good for you.
And the punch looked like it was the chest, the commentator thought maybe floating rib that you connected with.
Where exactly did you punch that dropped him?
I was aiming for his liver. Now, where it landed, I wasn't quite sure. But he was really hard to hit, I was head hunting. And so then I saw his elbow being picked up, and I got the gracious Oscar Martinez telling me to go to the body. So I did, and it worked out.
That KO, I think, gives you seven KOs in UFC, which puts you second behind Dustin Poirier for most in UFC lightweight history.
So what do you make of that rise to the record books?
You know, I got the ranking, and I'm not number one yet, so I'm not satisfied. So that's what I'm going for.
Did you say Terrence Crawford was? Yeah, my boy, man.
Anthony Smith, Dober, Bud, Terrence Crawford. And there's some in the water, Juan Brasquez, because we're producing fighters, and real good fighters, too.
Have you ever met him? Did you have a relationship with him? Yeah, Anthony, I mean, I grew up in MMA together, and then Terrence Crawford, and then when I worked on boxing,
he was gladly punching me in the mouth.
So I assume you're pimping up against Spence when that fight eventually happens. Are you going to try to go to that fight?
Yeah, absolutely. You know, I think Spence needs to sign that contract so that way Bud can make some money, and I'm all for that.
Obviously, at media day, you said you want to star opponents. You don't just want to fight guys that aren't going to bring all the attention. I know you kind of laughed at Patty Pimblett that was mentioned. You said you'd like to collide with that hype train.
Is there any other names that you want moving forward after this one?
You know, I think that Bobby Green fight. Bobby and I, that fight would be incredible. I'd love to do that. He's such a fun fighter. So I think that fight needs to happen eventually. He's not available this year. Man, Jim Miller would be really cool. I was looking up to him for a while. Man, if I pulled out the list of guys that I want to fight, it would hit the floor. And there's so many guys.
When you win, I think you're the one that when you finish your opponent, you go to knees, you don't get up until they get up, correct? Why is that?
You know, it's the ups and downs. I mean, very few fighters are undefeated. You know, we put our blood, sweat, and tears in every single moment we're in that cage. And so when my job is over, as soon as that ref stops it, I just want to show respect to the other man in the ring, the dance partner. I can't do this without him, and vice versa. That respect, and you know, the wrestling coach told me you gotta act like Ben there, right? So I've been visualizing this win for the last 8 weeks. So when it happens, I'm not surprised. So all respect to my opponent.
I gotta ask you one thing about that flurry you touched on a second ago, but did you catch he actually gave you a little finger wag there too during the whole moment?
There was actually a lot of commentary throughout the entire fight, man. We were shaking our head, dancing, smiling at each other. Yeah, I mean, whether he was doing it or I was doing it, we were pretty vocal in a positive way too.
Yeah, that's one of those things, like usually when you guys be so friendly, sometimes the fight doesn't necessarily play out like it did. Has that ever been a thing for you where you kind of have to need an animosity, so to speak, or does that not affect you at all?
So absolutely not. And this is just my belief, and that friends fight harder, right? Because what happens when you hate the guy, you don't want to lose the guy. So you fight like you don't want to lose, right? But Raphael Alves, I love that dude. So both him and I respect and loved each other. So we got out there, we performed to the best of our ability. We were taking chances, we were having fun. And I think that's what the audience wants to see. So I think fighters need to be friends more often, and managers are beat their friends up.
Lastly, how soon do you want to get back in there?
November. Because I'm here trying to celebrate Christmas. So if we can find a lightweight that wants to step in before, that'd be great.
Me too.
I know, right? Thank you so much, guys.